Hi, friends. Good evening, and thank you for tuning in to this evening's recital, a program of German Romantic organ music. Tonight, I'll be playing two works of Franz Liszt and Julius Reupke's Sonata on the 94th Psalm. I'd like to give a few insights into the music that I'll be playing. Regarded as perhaps the greatest pianist of all time, Franz Liszt's works for piano exhibit a virtuosic technique and showmanship inspired by 19th century violinist Niccolo Paganini. Tonight, we hear Liszt's first legend for piano, which he gave the programmatic title, St. Francis of Assisi Speaks to the Birds. As the story goes, the 13th century Catholic friar, deacon, and preacher St. Francis was traveling on a road when he stopped to tell his friends, "Wait for me while I go preach to my sisters, the birds." It is fabled that the birds listened to St. Francis intently and didn't fly away as he preached and practiced over and over his speaking. We hear these fluttery birds gathering to intently hear St. Francis in this work, characterized by the different flutes and strings of this symphonic Schoenstein instrument here at First Plymouth Church, which beautifully captures this sacred scene. Liszt's Ave Maria is based on the melody of a French chanson by Jacob Arkadelt. Liszt's adaptation of the work takes the form of a poetic lullaby characterized by its intimate registrations and simple texture. Enjoy these two works by Franz Liszt.
Thank you.
Before playing the second half of today's program, I would like to thank Pastor Jim Keck, Tom Trenny, and Ariel Merrillville for the opportunity to play this recital here today. I am very grateful to Tom DiPerna for all of his media work to make tonight's stream possible. Finally, I would like to thank my teacher, Peter Sykes, for his incredible teaching as we've navigated our lessons remotely these last months. And thank you for tuning in this evening. German composer Julius Reupke composed the Sonata on the 94th Psalm in 1857 at 23 years of age. At the time, he was studying with Liszt in Weimar. Reupke only lived 24 years, and this sonata was finished just a year before he passed of tuberculosis. Premiered on the Ladegast organ of Merseburg Cathedral, the sonata draws its influences from Liszt's symphonic poems and Wagner's operas. The fugue depicts God's judgment and victory over evil. The work furiously accelerates in tempo, ending in C minor sonorities, symbolizing the fire and brimstone of the day of judgment. In the state of our world at this time, this piece feels remarkably appropriate. I would like to read the 94th Psalm to contextualize this work that you're about to hear. The Lord is a God who avenges. O God who avenges, shine forth. Rise up, judge of the earth. Pay back to the proud what they deserve. How long, Lord, will the wicked, how long will the wicked be jubilant? They pour out arrogant words. All the evildoers are full of boasting. They crush your people, Lord. They oppress your inheritance. They slay the widow and the foreigner. They murder the fatherless. They say, the Lord does not see. The God of Jacob takes no notice. Take notice, you senseless ones among the people. You fools, when will you become wise? Does he who fashioned the ear not hear? Does he who formed the eye not see? Does he who disciplines nations not punish? Does he who teaches mankind lack knowledge? The Lord knows all human plans. He knows that they are futile. Blessed is the one you discipline, Lord, the one you teach from your law. You grant them relief from days of trouble till a pit is dug for the wicked. For the Lord will not reject his people. He will never forsake his inheritance. Judgment will again be founded on righteousness, and all the upright in heart will follow it. Who will rise up for me against the wicked? Who will take a stand for me against evildoers? Unless the Lord had given me help, I would soon have dwelt in the silence of death. When I said, my foot is slipping, your unfailing love, Lord, supported me. When anxiety was great within me, your consolation brought me joy. Can a corrupt throne be allied with you, a throne that brings on misery by its decrees? The wicked band together against the righteous and condemn the innocent to death. But the Lord has become my fortress, and my God, the rock in whom I take refuge. He will repay them for their sins and destroy them for their wickedness. The Lord our God will destroy them.